Okay, so we're going to be using Blender, and Blender is a tool which allows you to make sort of 3D graphics, animations, and environments. And as you can imagine, it's used everywhere, really. You know, if you want to work in advertising, if you want to work in gaming, if you want to work in like movie or TV industry. Even if you want to do things like, you know, if you run your own business and you want to do some advertising, you want some sort of 3D graphics or animation done, you can use Blender to do it. And, you know, for example, I've just got a quick example of something that somebody's made here in Blender. So you can see it's pretty, all of this is rendered in Blender. It's pretty good, you know, making pretty much photorealistic graphics. And if I just fast forward, you can kind of see, hopefully. So that's the sort of original models that they've made in Blender. And I think they've got a little bit where they've made, so that's like a scene there. And then I think if you sort of have a look at the different ways it's rendered. Okay, so you can see the graphics are very, very good. And you can use Blender to create this environment. So we're gonna have a little go at this today. And we're not going to make anything quite as intense as that yet, but obviously, you know, depending on how you get on, you can potentially do this. So when you open up Blender, just start with New File and General, okay? And you get this nice cube here. Now, the first thing to do, top right, is a little orb, okay? So up there, so it gives us the rendered view. And what this does, this allows us to move like the light source around, so we can see what the effect of like the light is going to have on the thing we're creating. So obviously like a light point is really important when it comes to things like animation and so on. So what we're going to build a little sort of monkey character. Now the first thing we want to do is get rid of this cube, okay, because we don't need that, right? So when you're using Blender, it's a combination of your mouse and keys on the keyboard. Okay, so I'm just going to kind of explain what to do. So you can see I've clicked on the cube already and it's selected. We can see it's got the orange light around it. Okay, and I am just going to press X on the keyboard. And when you press X, it comes up with, do you want to delete it? So we do, we'll get rid of it. Okay, and then we're going to import our little kind of monkey character in. And we want to go up to Add, Mesh, and down here at the bottom, Monkey. Okay, there's our monkey character. And before we do anything, what I want to do is to show you the different ways in which we can rotate the camera. Okay, now if you just sort of drag with your left hand button, you can see not a lot happens, it just selects things. So what we can do is, in the middle of your mouse you've got a wheel. Okay, now the wheel, if you move it in and out, will zoom in and out. Okay, now depending on the mouse you've got, if you hold the wheel down, so hold it down like a button and move it, you can see that moves the environment around with your mouse. Okay, so you can try that just very slowly. You can move the environment around. So hold the wheel on your mouse down and move it. Alternatively, if that doesn't work, top right, you see we've got all the different view axes. So Z, up and down, X and Y, okay, backwards, forwards. If you click and hold down on that and move your mouse, you get the same thing. Okay, so just click and hold down and move your mouse around. All right, but it's, I think it's easier to hold down the middle button and move your mouse around. So just get used to that and get used to the zoom tool. So using the mouse to zoom in and out. Now, you've also got a pan tool. Okay, so just here you can see it says move the view, it's a little hand. And again, if you click and hold on that, that will allow you to move the camera left and right, up and down and so on. Okay. So you've got pan tool, you've got this rotate tool, and you've got the zoom tool, okay? Now, you'll notice if I zoom out a touch, and I'm just gonna pan up a bit, I've got this bit here, okay? It looks like a little sun. Now that's our light source. And if we move that, okay, so I'm gonna click the move button on the left-hand side here, okay? What that will do is that allows to move the light around the object, okay? Now, I'm just gonna pan up again. You see it's developed these three, oops, let's just reselect it. It's developed these three arrows. So we've got the Z axis, which is blue, that moves up and down. red, okay, that will move, that's the x-axis, that will move sort of left and right. And if I move around, we'll see the green behind it, so that moves backwards and forwards, okay, because we're in a 3D environment, so we can move in all angles. So if I want to move along the sort of green line here, if I click and hold on the green arrow, okay, that will move the light in front of the monkey. And you can see there, you see the monkey changes because the shadows change depending on where you put the light. So I'm going to move the light in front of the monkey, and I'm going to move it down as well. Okay, so you can see if I move it down, the shadows will also change and get longer depending on the structure. Okay. And if I want to move it along the red axis, I'm just going to rotate for this one. So remember, hold the middle button down. We can get to the sort of red, and then we can move left and right. You can see there the shadows are changing. Okay, so just have a play with that and position the light where you want. All right. Now, the first thing we're going to do with our model is we're going to make a little hat for our monkey. Okay, and I'm just going to position the screen again so the monkey is reasonably in the middle of it. So I'm just going to use the pan tool. I'm going to zoom in a little tiny bit, not too much, and I'm going to go add and then mesh and then cone. Okay, so we've got a cone that's just appeared here. Now at the moment, if I move around just to show you where the cone is, so it's kind of in the monkey's head, okay, and we want to put the hat on top of its head. So have a think about what arrow we would need to move the cone upwards. Okay, so if you thought with the z-axis, you were right, so the blue, so I'm going to drag that up and just position that on the monkey's head, kind of about there. Again, I'm just going to move around just to check it's kind of looking all right. Yeah, that looks good. Okay, what we can also do is we can scale it, so you can move, make the object bigger and smaller. Okay, so the way to do that is if you put your mouse kind of away from the object, but make sure it's selected, just hold S on the keyboard, and you can see there, if I move my mouse now, I can make the object bigger and smaller. Okay, so I'm just going to make it a kind of reasonable size like that. Okay, cool. So we've got now our monkey with a hat on, all right. What we want to do is add some other features, like maybe its body. Okay, so what I'm going to do is I'm going to add let's go for a cylinder. Okay, we'll have the cylinder as its body. So I'm going to move this down a little bit. Okay, and I'm just going to scale it again. So pressing S and just sort of move it a little bit. Like this looks a bit slimmer. So that's sort of reasonably slim body for this monkey. And you can see it's not quite attached to the monkey's head there. Okay, so what I'm going to do is I'm going to make sure it's selected. And I'm going to go over here, see the left, the scale tool. And this time, you can see we've got those three planes again. So X, Y, Z. So I'm just going to make Z, and it won't get sort of wider, but it'll get longer. Okay. I'm just going to zoom around. Okay. There's my monkey's body. And I'm probably just going to maybe make it a little bit bigger. Okay. Let's have a look at that. Yeah, it's looking good. All right. And I'm just going to grab my light, I think, and I'm just going to have a little look around just to make sure, just to make sure it looks okay. So there's my light up there. Just going to make sure I go into move mode, remember, so we can move it where we want. Okay, yeah, that's looking good. Okay. So what I'd like you guys to try is see if you can get the body, get the hat on. You could put some decorations on the hat, like a little sort of sphere on the top, maybe, like a little clown hat. You could put some arms and legs coming out, okay? But just use this session just to get used to the idea of moving the camera, moving the light source, okay? And also scaling objects, okay? Making them bigger and smaller and so on, okay? Good luck, give it a go. So we want head, body, arms, legs.